George Mason, the story of an American Revolution hero. Written and directed by Rachel Rosenthal.
Also known as the central genius of the Revolution and the father of the Bill of Rights, George Mason IV was born on December 11, 1725 to George Mason III and Anne Stevens Thompson in Fairfax County, Virginia. He was a lively child who had no formal education until he turned 11, but he loved to read. When he was 10, his father died in a boating accident, and he moved in with his uncle, John Mercer. His uncle was said to have had a 1,500-volume library that George loved. These books he read helped him be able to read and write and be able to understand the world around him. He paid his teacher in tobacco, and the fee was 1,000 pounds of tobacco per year. Not much happened for George until 1747, when he was elected as a vestryman, also known as a church leader, for the Truro Parish and took a position as a military officer, where he eventually became a colonel. In 1748, at the age of 23, he ran for a seat in the Virginia House of Burgesses but lost to senior members. After running, he was appointed as a justice in the Fairfax County Court. He was a justice for much of the rest of his life but eventually resigned in 1789 because he didn't want to support the United States Constitution. Robert Rutland, the editor of Mason's papers, considered his court service a major influence on Mason's later thinking and writing. This shows that even though he liked to be out of the public eye, he was still important to Fairfax County. On April 4th, 1750, Mason married Anne Ellebeck of Charles County, Maryland. In 1753, he had his first child, George V. In 1754, he became a municipal trustee in Alexandria, Virginia. Not much is known about his political career in the 60s because he was opposing British policies, but here is what is known. In 1758, he ran for a spot in the Virginia House of Burgesses and won. He did not run for re-election, but worked with George Washington and James Madison, America's first and fourth presidents. In the Virginia House of Burgesses, he was stationed as a commander of Virginia's militia in the French and Indian War. In 1759, he was appointed to the powerful Committee on Privileges and Elections. In 1764, when the Sugar Act was passed by King George, George Mason and Patrick Henry wrote the Virginia Resolves, which stated that Virginians had the same rights as people who resided in Britain. He sent this to George Washington, and this led to a boycott of stamps until the Stamp Act ended in 1766. Mason continued working and worked on the non-importation of tobacco.
In 1773, his wife Anne passed away of pregnancy complications, giving birth to their 11th and 12th children. Now George Mason was a single parent of 9. When the Virginia House of Burgesses dissolved, the Fairfax County's house was established on July 5, 1774.
July 14, 1774, George Washington met with leaders including George Mason, and they drafted the Fairfax County Resolves, which was largely written by Mason. These resolves protested against British rule. When Washington became a member of the Second Continental Congress, he urged George Mason to fill Fairfax County's spot, and he did. Here, Mason was assigned to the Committee of Safety, a group that took over many issues dealing with the militia. May 1776, George Mason drafted the Virginia Declaration of Rights, which stated that all men are by nature equally free and independent and have certain inherent rights, of which when they enter into a state of society, they cannot by any compact deprive or divest their posterity. Namely, the enjoyment of life and liberty with the means of acquiring and possessing property and pursuing and obtaining happiness and safety. This was eventually drafted into the Declaration of Independence, written by Thomas Jefferson, Ben Franklin, and John Adams. The Declaration of Independence was officially released on July 4th after some editing. Mason continued to protest against British rule until the Treaty of Paris was signed in 1783 after the Battle of Yorktown. After that, he returned to Gunston Hall until 1787. In 1787, Mason led the Virginia Patriots and wrote the Virginia Constitution, and after writing that, he found problems with the U.S. Constitution. This is an example of why Mason is set apart from other founding fathers, because he opposed the new government. He even said, "I would rather chop off my right hand than put it to the new Constitution as it now stands." He never signed the Constitution and rallied against it, but he lost with a vote of 79-89. Mason came up with the idea of a Bill of Rights, but it was rejected until 1791 when James Madison created it. Mason died on October 7, 1792 at the age of 67 of natural causes. I think America wouldn't be the same without George Mason. Between his protesting and his pride for America, we are standing here today.